So I'm here with Imogen Ryall. So a bit about your career and tell us where it all began.
Well, I guess it actually, to be honest, it probably all began when my dad and mum both had a very kind of eclectic music collection. They liked all sorts. I mean, but they were both actors. So we had like musical theatre, we had jazz. I mean, he also played the piano. My dad. So we had Oscar Peterson and Art Tatum records, which I really. So I kind of was introduced to jazz piano certainly without really. Even being aware of it when I was very little. Scott Joplin, loved Scott Joplin. So, and of course Frank Sinatra, he had Frank Sinatra, and he had Aretha Franklin as well, and all sorts of different things. So I think I'd already kind of got that in my, you know, my DNA.
Music was always on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it was completely by fluke that I got into jazz. But when I was about 15 and sort of in the fifth year at school, I don't know what they call it now, it's year 10, I don't know, I'm terrible at. So we'd finished O-levels, and there was one of these things where they have a careers convention, and they have different representatives from colleges and different careers, and there was a representative from Chichester College, showing their various courses, and they had a jazz and pop music course. And I thought, wow, not the jazz at that point, the pop music kind of. I thought, can you study pop music? I was like, wow. So I applied for that, and for some, you know, reason, I got in. I wasn't a singer then, I wasn't singing. I mean, I'd always sung, but yeah. It wasn't my sort of first study, if you like. I'd kind of auditioned as a pianist, and I think they must have had very few pianists auditioning, because, you know, I wasn't that good. But anyway, I got a place, and yeah, it was wonderful that year. I got introduced to like Billie Holiday, I heard for the first time, Ella Fitzgerald, singers that sort of I've loved ever since, you know. And from then, I did another course in Salford for a year, another jazz course, and then I had a year out, and then I went again. Lucky to have got a place at the Guildhall on their jazz course, and again opened my eyes and ears to so many different sorts of jazz, a lot of British jazz.
Yeah.
Norma Winstone, another of my idols now, John Taylor, Kenny Wheeler, and Loose Tubes, who I featured a week or so ago. And then from then I started doing gigs. You know, in London, I was living in London then.
Whilst doing the course, or?
I sort of finished, the course was like a year long. It was 88 to 89. So it's a while ago now. After I finished the course, I started doing some gigs. And I did a few gigs with NYJO, which is the National Youth Jazz Orchestra. Since then, just been sort of doing the same sort of thing. I started writing lyrics. Probably, I'd always written lyrics, but not only just for my own enjoyment, really. And then I wrote some lyrics to a tune by Charlie Parker called My Little Suede Shoes. And I always loved the tune, but I wrote some words to it, and I did it on a gig. I didn't tell anybody, and they just said, oh, nice words, where'd you get those? And I sort of said, well, I wrote them, you know. So it was quite nice that I thought it encouraged me, you know. To sort of do some more. So ever since then, I've kind of done quite. I've actually written quite a lot of lyrics now too.
We'll leave it there. Thanks for coming in today. All the best for the future, Imogen. And we're going to see you again
Mark.
Today.
Thanks.
Cheers. Thanks.